can almost see the fields of bluegrass green. You can almost hear them cry as the kisses are torn to the ground. Oh, I wonder how the world's gonna
fix that. to blame, dog.
Right and across, how you do? Back to the left, how are you? Come forward, around you go, try your corner, don't be dull. Now your partner on the go.
The Daybreak Blues. I woke up this morning at the break of dawn. When I woke up this morning at the break of dawn, well, the mean old low-down man, he done your lady. Well, when I met you once, I had me a brand new pair of shoes. Well, when I met you, woman, I had me a brand new thank you.
up here, buddy. Let's do another square dance. What do you say? They've had enough of a break. Let's get them on the floor and pair it up.
Now hold on tight and turn around. MasterCard charge.
Yeah. like I said, me and Randy, we love history.
Right.
And we want to preserve as much of the old time music and the old time, like the square dancing, as much as we can. And so, let me ask you a few things. So how long have you been coming here?
How long been coming to McGann's?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness, I don't know. 30 years, I guess.
30 years, wow.
Wrong soul, yes.
So can you tell me some of the changes that have happened in the past 30 years since you've been coming?
Well, the floor's got worse.
I noticed it was a little soft out there.
Yeah. I was going to say, it used to be a little softer than it is now. No, not a whole lot. I mean, you know what I'm saying? It's not a whole lot of difference other than, like I said, the floor's getting pretty soft.
Yeah. Well, tell me, how important is it that we keep this old-time tradition going?
Well, I've been working myself to death at it for the last 20 years, trying to keep it going.
Yeah?
I teach dancing all over.
Do you really?
Oh, yeah.
That's nice.
Yeah, I teach square dancing. I'm going to have to teach some around here, because we ain't got nobody wants square dance now.
Oh, yeah.
It used to be we'd have a whole floor for it.
Really?
Yeah, oh, yeah. Yeah, man. I mean, I can't believe really tonight. I mean, it's nobody, but I mean, it wouldn't take me long to teach a whole bunch of these kids if they want to learn,
yeah,
you know, enough to be able to dance good, yeah. You know what I'm saying?
So but, what do you think it is that has made it that way, or what is something that you think would help to get more young people involved in it?
Well, I don't know really what is. I mean, that's, of course, my kinfolk, the younger ones, they get right in there after. But now everybody else's, you know, don't.
Right.
It's not like it is in the family, you know what I mean?
Right.
But I don't know. I tell you what, dancing in general, to me, I think people just got too dang lazy to dance. Dance that hard.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Because in the last 30 years, I can see such a difference in people. I mean, they just, you know, and there's a world of people that just, they really just too damn lazy to dance, dance hard.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And square dancing, it can get pretty.
Well, I can tell, man.
It can get pretty tough if you get going, you know what I'm saying? I love square dance, and that's what, I like to dance any kind of dance, but I like square dancing.
Yeah.
Always did, but used to be, my goodness, we'd have circles that go around this building.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, at different places, you know. But
so,
I haven't seen that kind of a crowd square dancing years.
Right.
Now, up at Cliff Top, West Virginia, I teach up there. I've had a big crowds up there, but now around here, no.
Really?
Yeah.
So, like, around here, let's see how to ask this. Would this be the only place around that would have square dances, or would they happen like multiple times a week? Or?
Well, when I was a kid, or I mean back years ago, it wasn't if he's going square dancing on Saturday night. It was where you was going, and they was three or four places you could go
in
square dance. Oh,
so,
yeah.
So what about now? Is it not like that anymore?
Not that I know of.
Yeah.
If they're square dancing anywhere, they're hiding it.
Really?
Yeah, I know. That's it's not what it used to be at all.
Yeah.
But I really think that if, you know, with the right kind of, I mean, if you get some interested in it, then others will follow.
Right.
But you know, you got to really get it going. The last time I taught square dancing around here was in Owensboro down at the senior citizens.
Oh, yeah.
And I had it free for everybody. Anybody wanted to come there and bring a half a dozen kids or whatever, I didn't care. But we had very few interested in it, you know what I mean?
I hear you.
But there just ain't enough good square dances going to get it going, you know what I mean? One thing is, I mean, of course, we're running out of good fiddlers. They can fiddle this old stuff, you know what I mean?
Yeah, those old songs we've got to keep those things going.
You're exactly right. You're exactly right. We're running out of good old fiddle, good old time fiddle, different players, yeah. You know.
Yeah, and I know Randy. Randy's really passionate about that.
Oh, yeah.
And keeping those.
John was probably one of the best, and they say that my great granddaddy was, that John played with him a lot, and John played a lot of my great granddaddy's songs.
Oh, really?
Yes, yes. Uncle Jim Rhodes, they called him. I reckon he was a heck of a fiddle player.
Really?
And John played a lot of songs that he wrote. Several things. I mean, Jim Rhodes' Breakdown and several things, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
John tried to keep them going, you know. John was probably one of the best. I mean, I travel all over. I dance festivals and stuff, and John was probably the best fiddle dancer. I mean, fiddle player for dances there was.
Really?
Yeah, they just didn't come no better.
That's good.
It's hard. A good fiddle player is not a good dance fiddle player. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Most of them wins these contests, you can't dance to.
Right. You know? Yeah, I hear you.
That ain't what you need for. You need an old time man. You know.
Yeah.
It's got that lick.
Yeah.
That's the way John always put it. You gotta have that lick.
Yeah.
You know.
Well. Listen, I appreciate you talking to me.
No problem.
And I thank you so much. And man, hopefully we can make a difference and keep this stuff going.
So.
And preserving some of these traditions. So.
Right. Like I said, I've been trying myself to keep dancing going, you know what I mean?
I hear you.
Anytime I can, because I've been sick the last 2 or 3 years. Just now getting back on my feet.
Really?
I had cancer.
Oh.
In fact, I still got cancer, but I'm back dancing. I can't get too wild on this square dancing as I used to, because I spin too many times, I get dizzy.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I'm the same way. I can't spin.
I used to could. Lord, I could spin all day, but I can't now.
Yeah, I noticed a few people out there were getting pretty dizzy.
Yeah, you can get dizzy if you ain't careful.
Oh, man. Well, I appreciate you talking to me. I think I'm going to slip over here and see what Mr. Newland has to say. So, thank you a lot.
Right,
appreciate it.
No problem.
Picture granddad up there.
Hey, I'm gonna go out front and do our interview out front.
Okay.
A little cooler.
Yeah, I'll be good.
Some good sound or whatever.
Right, you just talk to me, Elvis. So,
okay.
So tell us about the Wildwood Flyers, where we're at here in Magan, Kentucky.
That's correct, right? Here in Magan Station, Kentucky. We've been here, I think, I started this in around 1978.
Wow!
And we've been going ever since. There's been a lot of good music played here. And your granddaddy, John Lanham, he was one of the leading bands. He played here for many, many years, and one of the best, and a good person with it. What I call salt of the earth, you know.
Oh,
just a good man, and he knowed all the old tunes. It wasn't a tune that I could name it. He couldn't just hit it and go right on with it. It always amazed me how he could remember all those tunes up here and how they went, but he did.
Yeah,
he was the best, and we've had a lot of fun here at this place. Place you could bring a whole family, children and adults, and have a good time and eat a hamburger and have some popcorn and a cold drink, and just have a great time for not very much of a charge, you know.
So yeah,
we've experienced a lot of good times here in Magan.
We sure have, and I have come up here.
Yes,
well, this
indeed.
Is where I met you, probably, or either in Granddad's basement doing a jam session, or here, because I come up here many years with Granddad to play these square dances.
Absolutely.
When I tell people about Magan and the square dances up here, I tell them it's like it's walking back in time. I feel like I'm walking back into old time. When I come into this building, we do this, not only the music, but watching the dancers. And I just love it up here. It's authentic.
That's
authentic square dance.
They come to have a good time, and they like to dance here. And that's when I would be playing with your granddad a lot, and even you, we'd be playing and to look out there and seeing them enjoying it. So your granddad would say, now they're feeling it now.
Yeah.
That music was so good. And like I say, he told me about you, said, when I started with Randy, I told him a little tune called Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star.
Yeah.
Play that, and then from there you developed into something great. Just a great musician.
Well, that's all
a
because...
good person with it.
Well, I appreciate that, but that's because of people like you and places like McGann, where I got to be around good, authentic people. Just good people and good musicians, you know?
Oh, yeah.
So this place is so great, and I love it. Like you said, it's a family place.
It is.
You see all ages in there.
And I think some of your granddad's people might have been that from here. Lawrence Lanham would have been your great-grandfather. John would tell me about we'd be playing tunes, and he said, now this is my daddy's old tune, especially that Whistling Rufus, you know?
Yes.
He would play it, and it'd just be beautiful. Just like sitting in a rocking chair, rocking everything just as smooth. But we've had a lot of good times, and thanks to people like you and John, Jordan Evans, and Butch Edge, all of them, Martin Cecil, that played here for many years.
Yeah.
And we miss them, although they're gone, but I'm glad to have you to play tonight. At least the music's been carried on.
That's right. Granddad always told me, he said, pass it down, Randy, pass it down. He told me that 1,000 times. Pass it down. And I'm trying to do that. I teach a lot of students.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm so glad to see the old time dancing still going on. Yeah. Now, you talk about my family being from here. When me and my dad was driving just down the road here just a while ago, he said, that's where my granddad used to live, right there. And he pointed right across the road.
That's right.
So yeah. My great granddad grew up right here.
Yeah. Lawrence Lane.
Lawrence, yeah. I guess he lived just right there,
yeah,
didn't he?
Yeah, he did.
Just a house right across the road there.
Yeah, and then John's aunt, Dylan, she lived over in that house with the porch lights on right there.
Is that right?
Dylan, and she married Alec McGann. And I remember them when I was real small.
Yeah.
Good people.
Yeah.
But we appreciate you and appreciate having you. One time, I'll tell you a little tale. They was from the college in Owensboro. Said there was a group of college kids from all over the state was touring rural places.
Uh-huh.
And they chose to come here. They brought a bus here, a whole load of them. And your granddaddy was playing that night, John. And those kids had the best time of their life. They got off, it was in the summertime. They wasn't a dry thread on them. All of them was jumping and dancing, and they just loved it. And there's things like that that makes me happy. I love to see people have a good time.
Absolutely. Like you had said earlier, and like Granddad would say, I can remember being here all these years ago and even tonight. And when we're getting it right, we're playing a good tune, and you're seeing them dancers out there dance right to the beat, and they're all smiling, they're all having a good time. Boy, ain't that a good feeling?
It is a good feeling. You sort of get, even though you're up there, you get into it with them.
Yeah,
know?
That's right.
Yeah, but it's just great.
And you're multi-talented. You, not only do you run the store, the square dance here, but you play the spoons, you call the square dances, and you are a square dancer.
Yeah.
So you do it all.
I do it all, yeah. I really, when I first started, I never danced, and I went to Rose Inn, and they had their community dances up there. So I started, and they had some old-time callers. Hiker Patterson was for one, and I would listen to the calls, and I told myself one day, I think I could do that, so I sort of taught myself and the calls according to what they done, and I really enjoy calling the music.
I was just fixing to ask how you got started, so that's how it started.
That's how it started, and then when you look at the dancers out there, and they're with you, and they're listening to you, and they're doing the calls with you, it's really a good feeling, and the music good, you just call to the music, keep time with it, and everybody's in step, it's just really good.
Well, I got to tell you, I mean, you probably when you started in the late 70s, you talked about, it was a little bit of a leap of faith thinking, you know, is anybody going to show up to a square dance or not? Or was that popular at the time?
Well, at the time, of course, this old building was a store, and it was just abandoned. So it just sitting here in the town. So I said, I need to. I bought it, and then I sort of done some repair to it. And I said, to have a dance and bring people in here and bring life to it. It's just like bringing somebody back to life. And this old building, like I say, if it could talk, it could tell you about all the good times and the good music's been played.
Yeah.
And it was just something else. Even Gene Lanham, Judge Lanham, he helped on when I was building the east and west wings on it. It was growing, so we had to expand. I built on to it, and he helped me build a stage. Said, we need a little stage. He come up here and helped me build a stage and stuff, and it made it a lot better. It was just great.
Yeah, well, that's funny. Talk about Judge Gene Lanham. Of course, he's a left-handed fiddler.
Oh, yeah.
And he's not Ken Lanham. Well, a lot of people always thought he was my uncle or my dad growing up, and I'd be like, no, another set of Lanhams, we're kin somewhere along the line. But you got a fiddle player up here that's a judge, and then you was sheriff for how many years?
I was sheriff for about almost 18 years.
Almost 18 years you was the sheriff up here. So we have a sheriff and a judge up there on the stage calling the dances and playing for the square dancers.
Yeah. I could always tell Gene play that old tune called Up Jump the Devil, and boy, he could really make them go. It was fun.
What's some of the other songs that Granddad would play? You said Whistling Rufus.
That was his daddy's old tune, and he loved that Tennessee Wagner.
Yeah.
And then he played When the Leaves Turn Brown.
Yeah.
He favored a lot of Tommy Jackson's old square dance tune.
Yeah.
And boy, they were great. You know, he said, oh, there's a barrel full.
Thank you.
And we just have another square dance. What do you say?
All right, get your partner, put on the floor. We're trying to do kind of do the right hand across one more time here. The whole team called Lost Indian. Now everybody get on the partner, get on the floor.
People into this thing. If we can, if anybody tell them that, I'll show them how they want to dance.
Come on, get your partner down on the floor. We need more than just two couples. We need some more people on the floor. Dennis will show you there. He'll show you how to do it. Walk you through.
Thank you.
with a dog up
just
here.
A few minutes, just asking a few questions about family over there.
He played up here before, just a great professional musician, along with the rest of this band. And Randy's granddaddy was one of my dearest friends. His name was John Lattimer. He played 50 times up here at Magan at the dancing hall. He's gone on now, and hopefully I know he's playing in heaven all them good tunes we used to play. So I'm so proud that Randy could come and help carry on the tradition. And they wasn't a tune that I couldn't name, but John Lattimer couldn't just jump up and play. And that's saying a lot. And his daddy played the field too. His name was Lawrence Mount. And John would tell me when we'd be playing, he said, that's my daddy going to be in there. He had a lot of fun here, along with the rest of us. And I appreciate all of you coming out to the band and sharing it with us. Thank you.
This is the coolest place in the world. Y'all are great people out there, I tell you right now. Next time we'll do this, just bring it back. Just throw this pack to pass me. Thank y'all so much. Thank you, Elvis.
Yeah, thank y'all.
Right across the street here, we always called her Aunt Dylan, which was my dad's aunt. And she was a McGann. She's married on to Chester McGann. And I guess that's what this town is named after. I don't know. But my granddad was born right across the street over here. And he lived there until he was about 30. My brother Warren and myself, we used to play on these roads up down through here, and it wasn't nothing but gravel. And we were barefooted too.
Oh my goodness. Yeah.
And another real good friend that I liked up here a whole lot was Link Medkiff. He was a fine old gentleman. He's not with us anymore, but I tell you what, he stood right here about where we're standing right now and told me stories about the steps on the porch and about the buggies turned over when they made the corner.
Oh, man.
Different things. But I remember they used to have a croquet yard around here. Some of Dad's cousins lived up in here. Matter of fact,
right
over there in the Rough Creek, which is right at the end of this road. So, let's just stop there.
Oh, okay. That'd be good. That's okay. Fine. That's good stuff. Yeah. Yeah. That's good stuff.
Right back beside Rough Creek where they used to live.
Yeah, they lived down there in Beach Valley.
Okay, Beach Valley. I knew it had a name to it. But yeah.
Call it Johnson Holler now, but it was Beach Valley.
I got the old crack telephone they used to have.
Yeah.
I bought it when they still lived over there.
Yeah.
You know, hang your mic sits up down there, want to get rid of it, let her go.
No, Keith, he knows more about it. He's been around here and married one of the Doolins, see?
Who's that?
Keith.
Where'd he go?
There he is.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. I'll tell you what.
He knows a lot of history.
Was a dancing fool.
Yeah, she loved to dance.
I seen him run over that way. I don't know where he went.
Yeah, John and Art were good friends. He liked to watch her dance, and she liked to fit.
You'll freeze.
Hey, the best.
You freeze death night going on there.
I'll tell you what.
Yeah, I brought a hoodie, but
she was from a mighty good family.
Oh, yeah. The Doolin family's great.
It really ain't that bad.
I was blessed to be married into that family.
That'll help.
Another brother married to mine.
Robin. Joy, yeah. That's my younger brother, Joy.
Okay.
Yeah.
See, you're coming back close to the old time.
Yeah.
See, Paula is my sister, Roger's wife.
Oh, okay. I tried. Yeah. Okay. Well, see, John, my brother, and Roger were best friends.
Oh, right.
You remember John? He got killed in a car wreck a few years ago.
Okay. Maybe.
And John and Roger were, every time you seen one of them, you seen the other one for all through high school and after that. So.
Roger and Roger used to have it long hair.
Oh, yeah. My brother did too, John. Yeah.
That was the thing back then.
Yeah. They were good friends. I went to school with Danny.
Oh, really?
Danny and I are a year older than John and Roger. Yeah.
you know, bad about Danny's daughter, and she got kicked back here.
Yeah, well, we have a lot of accidents. We don't care anything about, right? Yeah. So,
I forgot to tell you, Duffy.
Well, I'm talking.
Well, it is a cool place. I tell you
what, him and Neil were there.
Oh, yeah. They were sick. Yeah. We went down to Fiddler's Contest making with them one time. Was you down there when we went down there?
Muffin Bird?
I think it was, what was it? Somewhere down in Alabama. Yeah, I believe it was. Anyway, we went down there for a weekend. John and Elvis and the whole bunch went down there. And of course, Garnet wanted to go, so we followed him down there. Spent the weekend. That's a great time.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't get to play contest stuff.
No.
He just liked to go jam.
Well, they found a place out there. You know how they do down in places. They found a place out there kind of at the edge of the parking lot, and they played all day.
Yeah.
And they just one song right after another, and then there would be another musician come in and they'd switch out. Of course, Garnet and them were all dancing out there, you know, and it was great. It was a great time.
I tell you what, when they get to dancing, he just come alive.
Yeah, he liked to see Elvis and Garnet dance together. You remember that?
Oh, yeah.
Elvis and Garnet kind of had the same step as their brother. And, John really enjoyed them dancing together.
Clear, straight up.
Their dad.
Straight up.
I remember him, but Mr. Dooley's wife, she was sitting here one night. Told Dad, said, look at Mom. And she was petting her feet, petting her head.
She could barely get around. I remember she would sit up here.
Yeah.
And they could, after a while, she got where she couldn't dance. But like you're saying, she'd sit there and pat her feet. But every once in a while, they'd get her out there. And she could do it now. She could do it. And she's the one that had the dancing in it. It was on their mother's side. Her name was Ida B. Dooley. Ida B., yeah. Sweet lady.
That's well said.
Thank you.
In fact, I think I still got a list of them where he had rolled out.
Yeah.
And I copied them down, you know. But he was, there wasn't hardly anything I couldn't name, though. He just couldn't come right off the top of his head, start it, and go right on with it.
And that band, they would all play together so well, they just lay down that beat. Easy for everybody to dance to, wasn't it?
It was. It sure was. It would make you, even if you didn't have dancing in you, it'd be so good you'd want to get out there and do something, you know.
Yeah, even if you wasn't part of the square dance.
That's right.
Some butt dancing or freestyle dancing, right?
Yeah, that's right.
Just had to move.
Yeah.
You remember all those years? I remember going to some of them contests in Tennessee and Alabama, and you went with us a few times. And you remember when we would start playing, Granddad always played the old-timey square dance tunes.
Right.
And then them buck dancers would be coming from everywhere. They'd throw down them boards around, and boy, they'd be dancing all day long, wouldn't they?
Yeah, we chartered a bus one time, and all of us went to Murfreesboro, Tennessee. And John and them played down there for us. Boy, they was coming in there from everywhere he was playing. And we had some great music and a good time that day. And then I think I believe it, John and Floyd Stewart and all of us went to the Capitol one time and played for the inauguration. I believe it might have been for one of the governors, Fletcher, I believe.
Uh-huh.
Governor Fletcher. We went up to the Capitol and played representing Ohio Capitol.
Yeah.
It was great. And they had all these bands, horns and drums and stuff, but when we got up there and struck up that tune up, jumped the devil down, my head was just popping up everywhere. And we played a lot for the nursing homes, and
yes.
We also went to the mall and played every year for the senior day out at the mall.
Mm-hmm.
So many elderly people would come from everywhere just to get to hear us play there. And we played one time when the executive inn was going for a postal retirement party they had.
Uh-huh.
And we had a lot of fun. And John and June and Floyd and Martin, all of them. I could always count them. They'd be right there.
Yeah.
Instruments.
I'm going to circle back to that. So I was so privileged to grow up with Granddad and then knowing you and all the rest of them later on. But, you know, you talked about playing in a nursing home. That was something that was always important. Not just, I mean, it's good to play at a dance, play somewhere, but when you're going to playing for the senior citizens, when you're going playing for elderly folks that are in nursing homes, that was always something that was important to y'all,
yeah,
wasn't it?
Yeah, it was, very much so. Because when you left the nursing home, all of them gathered around their wheelchairs and such, and you go, they'd all shake your hand, and they just enjoyed it so much.
Yeah.
And one time I remember we were playing up at Fordsville Nursing Home, and one of the people couldn't come down to where we were playing, so we went to the room and played. I said, let's step up to the room and play a little song for one of them fast tunes. And she had a sheet over her feet, and I could just see her toes wiggling as we played. She just loved it. So that big smile on her face.
Yeah.
And it just made me feel so good.
Yeah.
And all the rest went. And I appreciate them so much, because I can't say how many times we played at the Senior Citizen Center in Hartford. And the people, they just really enjoyed the music.
It's such a blessing, ain't it, to be able to bring such joy to other people.
It was.
Through our God's gifts to us,
exactly,
and when we
right.
Share with other people, it feels good, don't it?
It does. It certainly does. And I feel blessed that I was given the talent to play the spoon, call the square dance, and to be, you know, mingle and mix and mingle with the people. I feel blessed to do that. I always love to, it's like cooking a big dinner. I like to cook, but it does me more good to see everybody eat.
Yeah.
And that's much like playing music and dancing.
Yeah. Elvis, thank you so much. Yeah.
I thank a lot of you. I always watch your TV shows on our own.
Well, thank you.
I enjoy them very much. And I thank you for all the good that you bring and do for the ministry.
Oh, thank you. I appreciate you saying that. And thank you for taking your time out today. And it's so good to be back here playing. I hear them playing right now. They probably wonder where the fiddle player is. So I guess I ought to get on back in there.
Okay. Well, good having you on.
Thank you
very much.
Oh, that was good.
That was perfect, buddy. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.